Okay, we have both Ashwin and Mitesh now joining us. So let's get straight to them and get their trading calls for the day. Good afternoon, Ashwini. What would be your call for the last hour, and what would be your stock calls?
Well, I think we are setting up for a large directional upside move, and I'll tell you why. If you see the S&P 500 chart, I think the Dow fell 450 points a day before, and it's making a kind of a sideways flag sort of a pattern, which means the upside will start at some point. So our market seems to be anticipating the continuation of the rally on S&P 500. Plus, we did try to reject the 200 DMA yesterday. And if just after a day of rejection you are coming back again to these levels, that just means that this 200 DMA resistance is not very strong, and chances are sooner or later it will get taken out. Now, my belief is that given the great amount of advertising this level has received, if we get past this 10,000, what, 10,900 thereabouts, there is going to be massive short covering. So given that Reliance and Bank Nifty both are now revving up, my sense is that market is going to make a meal out of this, and chances are very soon, maybe in the next 5 to 7 days, you should be at 11,000. So that way, what we've done is we had started with ranging positions on the options. Now we've covered the short calls and still long on, several calls and sold puts, plus the Bank Nifty 23,000 call can still be bought. My sense is financials are not done yet. So that way, large stocks are coming back. Having said that, Bajaj Finance is a buy with a stop of 3,300, target of 3,450. RIL is a buy with a stop of 1,800, target of 1,865. And HDFC is a buy with a stop of 1,900, target of 2,050. And these are the basic three reasons why you should be long on the market.
Okay, that's an emphatic point you've made, Ashwini. We're going to keep that in mind. Mitesh, let me get in your views as well. Now, if someone's just trailing their stops and riding their longs, it's a great place to be in. But does one have the stomach to buy a fresh now at 10,800? What would your advice be on the index and stocks?
So I think we have been looking for consolidation in the market. I think that process is on. Once we get past yesterday's high, I think the 200 average is at about 10,880, 885 levels, and around those levels you might see supply and profit booking emerge. So I think overall the structure is good, but after a rally I think we're just kind of consolidating or building some base below the 200 average, possibly in anticipation of eventually breaking it on the upside. So for the time being, avoid the index. We are trading with stock specific bias. If you have index positions, 10,830, 850 is a good zone to take profits and see if we are actually able to get past 10,900. I think that will add another 200, 250 points kind of target on the upside. Till then, trade with stock specific bias, and I have two buy calls. The first one is a buy on Ambuja. The cement pack is having a good breakout, so buy with a stop at 196 for targets of 210, and ACC is a buy with a stop at 1316 for targets of 1365.
Okay, that's some calls for last hour of trade. We have Espetulsian of espetulsian.com joining us now, and along with him, Amrish Paliga is also joining us. Good afternoon, Mr. Tulsian. I wanted your thoughts first on a couple of these stocks making a bit of a comeback. NCC and Century Textiles. We'll talk about the larger stocks as well, but first, I want to focus on some of the mid caps which are moving.
So Anuj, I think two combination factor. Firstly, for NCC, the management commentary on the order inflow. Maybe they may have trimmed the top line execution this one, but the order inflow is seen to be very much in place. The management has indicated that for FY21, they are aiming for a target order inflow of about 10,000 crore. Of that, 2,500 crore has already been backed by them in Q1. And mind it that April was total washout, and back maybe the execution problem is seen because the state government have asked the company, you know, to go slow in the month of April and May. Now that problem also is seen having been behind. So overall, the EPC stocks are seen to be really very, very, very good going forward, and they are into the water projects and road construction, and both are seen to be having good prospects going ahead. And the kind of valuation, the margin of safety or the valuation comfort you have on NCC, probably, you know, maybe at this price can give a very good appreciation in the next 6 to 9 months, purely on the execution, fundamental and order inflow. Coming specifically on Century Textile, two or three things, you know, which I've checked on the, while you check on the ground report. Firstly, that stock is seen in accumulation. Secondly, the Q1 numbers are scheduled for 14th July, that is on Tuesday. And always, if you see the Century Textile, they always declare their Q1 numbers in the end of the month. That means the end of the next month of that quarter. So this time, people are expecting that probably the bottom-out process has seen happened. And in fact, for the last maybe 1 month or so, the stock is holding a level of about 300 rupees. And in fact, if you see this, these kind of stocks in accumulation, in fact, we have formed this pattern about maybe 6 months back. And when you say this type of pattern getting formed, that means there could be a big breakout likely to be seen once the accumulation gets over. So purely on a fundamental basis, looking to their working of the paper project and real estate, which they are holding on or where the development work is going on, and the current valuation of 5,000 crore market cap or EV of 5,000 crore looks very, very attractive. So maybe 300 rupees could be seen as a good support, but going on the upside, the stock has good upside potential. Maybe 10% can be seen in this month itself, or maybe about 15 to 20 months, 20% appreciation in the next 3 to 4 months. So that's the reason for taking a or studying the accumulation patterns seen in the Century Textile for last 3-4 days.
Okay, that's a view coming in from Mr. Tulsian on those specific stocks. Amrish Baliga is also with us this afternoon. Amrish, good to have you on the show. What are your thoughts on this big metal rally that is playing out? I mean, the underlying metals themselves, base metals, have been doing really well. I think most of them are at multi-month highs. Would you look at a stock like Hindalco or a Tata Steel or a JSW Steel at all?
Although they have moved up, I think there is some more move left, as of now. And we have been hearing that the major steel mills would be increasing their prices for July deliveries. And, the sort of dumping which was happening earlier from China, that's clearly stopped as of now. So that's another positive for the metal space. So I think stocks like Tata Steel can still see an up move from here of another 10 to 12% at least. I mean, if you're looking at Nifty at about 11,000 plus levels over the next few days, I think we should see about 10 to 12% sort of a rally in Tata Steel. I think something like a Nalco, which hasn't been moving, can actually see levels of about 44 to 48. And surely stocks like Hindalco, JSW Steel, I think these should be bought, at least from a trading point of view. From an investment angle, I would say that possibly it's a time to wait and not really jump into the market right now when there's so much of momentum. Because whatever said and done, there's a lot of gap between the sentiment in the market and the sentiment at the ground level. I mean, if you're talking to the entrepreneurs and the businessmen at the ground level, there's a huge difference in sentiment. So I think somewhere the reality will catch up. But as of now, when the going is good, utilize this time to trade in and trade out. And metals surely is a good pack to get in right now.
Okay, by the way, the stock that's moving up right now is Zee Entertainment. The Delhi High Court has stayed the sale of pledged shares of both Zee Entertainment and Dish TV by IDBI Trusteeship, and they will be hearing the SL Group plea. So that's a bit of an overhang taken out. So that's why you're seeing a bit of a move in Zee Entertainment. Just pull out the intraday chart on that stock. Zee Entertainment right now is moving up. It's a stock which had seen, of course, a lot of pain, but now that there's going to be no sale of these shares, move coming up. Mr. Tulsian, your thoughts on Zee Entertainment? Of course, that's the news we're just breaking right now, but that should be a bit of a positive.
Anuj, this news is definitely positive for both the stocks, because when you see this kind of pledge share sale is not coming in market, obviously you have that kind of less supply. But we have been keeping, and in fact, we won't be taking a positive call on Dish TV going forward, but yes, definitely on Zee Entertainment, we have been keeping positive call for the simple reason that it will be a policy to treat Subhash Chandra Steel as the promoter of the company, because they are just there for namesake. maybe when the transition happens, you know, they will be moving out. They are the old promoter, that is Subhash Chandra family, is just holding less than 5%. In fact, I give the example of the SL Propec, where the brother Ashok Goel has sold the stake, and you know, thereafter the stock has moved up by about 25-30%. So probably it's G Entertainment is in a transition phase. Once you see the existing promoters going out, because financial investors are holding about 70% stake. In fact, even if the pledge share sales comes in the Z Entertainment case in the market, they will get lapped up by those financial investors, obviously at a lower level, maybe at 160 or so. And that will be a loss to the promoter, the old promoter, because they have pledged their shares in their personal capacity. It has nothing to do with the company. And if you take a call on going forward on FY22 with a maybe market cap of closure to about 16,000-17,000 crore, maybe P multiple in the single digit of such a established channel and with so many channels and bouquets, entertainment and all sort of things, is definitely looking a good buy. So yes, this news of Delhi High Court having stayed the sale is seen positive, but in the long-term or maybe medium-term positive view on Zee Entertainment, but may not be taking the same view on the Dish TV.
Okay, that's Zee Entertainment right now reacting to the news that is on your screens. We need to take a very quick break. On that note, we'll come back, keep tracking what's been another very, very robust day, at least for the frontline market. And just a reminder, we also get in views from Rakshit Ranjan of Marcellus today.